Remote Pilot 101, Jason here. Airspace is tough, but we also know airspace makes up a big part of our test, and airspace makes up a big part of our everyday operations. Look at this VFR sectional chart here with me. Orlando's airspace. To the north, you see that magenta, that solid magenta line showing the Class Charlie airspace of Sanford. You can see the dashed blue lines down south of Kissimmee showing the Class Delta airspace. You can see the solid blue lines of that Class Bravo airspace of Orlando. And when we look at it, in this two-dimensional view, it looks like a lot is going on. It looks like a lot of areas we can't fly, but nothing could be further from the truth, actually. You have to remember that airspace is three-dimensional, and let's look at it from a three-dimensional standpoint. Let's start with all the Class Deltas in this image. Class Delta airspace is from the surface, usually up to 2,500 feet. It's very much controlled airspace, so we would need a waiver or an authorization to operate in there, particularly because this airspace goes down to the surface, and we can see all of that here. Let's head north up to Sanford now. Sanford is Class Charlie airspace. This is where it gets interesting. Yes, we have that center cylinder that goes from the surface and it continues on up, actually until it reaches the Bravo airspace. But there's also a shelf there that you can see starts at 1,300 feet. I can operate under that shelf. I'm only going up to 400 feet. I'm outside of Sanford's airspace. Then let's look at how we build the Bravo airspace. There's a lot to the Bravo. There's the one area very, very few people are ever going to get permission to fly in, and that's the main center of that cylinder there that extends from the surface all the way up to 10,000 feet. But as you can see, there's a lot of other cylinders that kind of work around that, and a lot of shelves more so that we can operate under. Let's pull it all together now. Let's add in Sanford's Class Charlie airspace. As you can see how that plays into the mix. You can see all these spots where you can fly. Let's add in the Class Delta airports. And let's never forget that airspace is three-dimensional. I hope this video helps to serve you to take that 2D image and really break it out and realize just because it looks complex on paper, doesn't mean it's necessarily complex or it's a no-go or a no-fly area or an area you need an authorization or a waiver. It's videos like these that have made Remote Pilot 101 the most successful course on the market, now crossing over 20,000 passed tests, making us the largest Part 107 test prep on the market. What a blessing, and it's thanks to amazing clients and customers like yourself. Don't forget, we have our complete recurrent course as well, which I just finished filming a few months ago. Brand new course, and that is free to all of our lifetime customers. Or you could just buy the recurrent course. If you haven't been a customer of ours previously, you can just buy the recurrent course. But as our customers will tell you, we're always updating the course. We have some great things on the horizon in 2019 to unveil some great new designs and some great new videos.